Hi students, welcome to our English class. You know me, I am K. Saidulu, SA English, JPSS Ravinathala from Bonakal Mandal, Khammam District. So we discussed about snake on the mirror, something. Let us see, let us have a objectives of today's class. In this class, my dear students, you will be able to read and understand the lesson. You will be able to answer some simple questions which I just pose. You will be able to use the language in your own sentences while asking questions for interaction. You will be able to construct a few paragraphs even. Now, let us move to the next page. Look at this one. How to read the paragraph, how to read individually, we will see. When you are reading the paragraph, take a pen or pencil, don't forget to do this one. When you understand a sentence, put tick mark. When you don't understand the sentence, don't forget to put a question mark. When you see a sentence which you like most, put a star mark. Okay, this is the process of reading. So far we have gone through reading at least one slot. Now let us go to see the second slot. Before going to see the second slot, let us have a small discussion, small interaction over this picture. Here is a wonderful picture you see. Of course, we just saw this picture even in the last class. Let us once again take a look at this picture. Apart from thinking broadly and in other ways, let us think about the picture. Let us fix our thinking to this picture. What is there in the picture? You're right. You will see a snake. Who is the snake? Snake is beautiful. Let us discuss all these questions here. What do you see in the picture? Yes, you answered this question. Once again, just I am recalling. How many snakes are there in the picture? You're right. Only one snake is there. How many snakes are there in the picture? There is only one snake. Good. What is the snake doing here? The snake is looking its image or reflection? What is that? Yes, image, reflection. Why is the man in the picture running where? The answer came when we were reading something. He was just running out because the man was running out because he saw the snake. Do you think he's brave? How do you say? I'm sure he's no more brave. Of course, you also get the same answer. He is not brave. That's why he is running away. What do you do if you see a snake in your room? Quite natural. I also will run away like the man who is in the picture, this homeopath. Can you tell me some names of the snakes? We just discussed this matter. Let us go to the next slot. Let us read. Before reading this paragraph, just take a look at these meanings. Admirer means fan, a person who has a special regard for someone else. Look at this one. There is a word. How do you read? Let me see. This is in Telugu, Meesam. Mustache, bachelor, an unmarried person. Pace, speed, tempo. I see some pace bowlers. For example, Bumrah. Resume. Oh, you will see some other person like from Africa, from South Africa, you will see Rabada. Pace bowler. Resume. Begin speaking again. Thud. Look at this pronunciation of the word. Thud. Dull, heavy sound. Wriggle. What is that? Wriggle. Wriggle. Twist and turn quickly. Simultaneous. Done at the same time. Simultaneously. We will use this one. Let us go again to the paragraph. Actually, this paragraph has to be read in our school. It has to be read individually. Then it has to be done by group. Then it has to be presented by the teacher. Then it may be going for, yes, loud reading. Now, just try to look at the pronunciation, how I am just reading, and try to capture the meaning what you are going to get. One feels tempted to look into a mirror when it is near. I took a look. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty and I believed in making myself look handsome. I was unmarried and was a doctor. I felt I had to make my presence felt. I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting so that it looked straight and neat. Again, I heard that sound from above. Now, let us have some understanding over this paragraph. It is quite natural for everybody. Whenever a person sees the mirror, he gets tempted. Why? Mirror tempts or the person gets tempted. This is quite natural for every human being to see into the mirror when it is near. So, in the same sense, I am not separate from human beings. I also have the same human tendency. That is what the doctor says. Who is the doctor? Yes, the person who has been in the paragraph, I. I took a look. Who is I? Doctor. I took a look. Where did he look? Yes, you're right. He just looked into the mirror. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty. I don't understand why the beauty has been used for this man. But of course, he is an admirer of beauty. That's it. But he is not beautiful. Huh? How is he? He is handsome. Look at the word in the same line. Once again, let me read. In those days, I was a great admirer of beauty and I believed in making myself look handsome. He wants to be handsome. Look at this word handsome, beautiful, pretty. Handsome, repeat after me. Handsome, good, beauty, right, pretty, good. Handsome is especially used for men. Man, young man. Beauty, beautiful is specially used for women. Okay? And pretty is used for, yes, you are right, children. I was unmarried and was a doctor. Oh, he was an unmarried person and he was a doctor, we know already. I felt I had to make my presence felt. He wants to show he was there. I picked up the comb and ran it through my hair and adjusted the parting. So, actually, whenever somebody just goes to the mirror, it is quite natural feeling for everybody to go there and take the comb and part the hair. Parting. Parting means moving our hair into two parts, making a way on our head. This is you also do. Don't you do that when you go to the mirror? Don't laugh. Answer my question. Yes, you are right. It is quite natural for everybody. Whenever a person goes to the mirror, he just searches for a comb just to see again how the hair is. Again, I heard that sound from the above. So, in between, while we were discussing the lesson, the sound is coming into intervention. Now, let us go to next one. I took a close look at my face in the mirror. I made an important decision. What is a decision? Important decision. What is the opposite word if you are important? You are right. You are right. Unimportant. Decision. I would save daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. Okay? Meesam chala handsome ga penchalani. He tried his level best to. He decided on that day. I would save daily and grow. Saving, you know, shaving kit. Nowadays, most of the people are not saving. Instead, they are using what? Trimmers. I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor. He was just always remembering himself that he was a doctor. Bachelor means? Look at the meaning for this word again. Bachelor. An unmarried person. Good, you are right. Let us go again to our paragraph. Next paragraph. I looked into the mirror and smiled. It was an attractive smile. I made another earth-shaking decision. I would always keep that attractive smile on my face. To look more handsome, I was after all a bachelor and a doctor too on the top of it. Again came that noise from above. Now let us take a quick look at this one again. I looked into the mirror and smiled. Smile, smiled, smiled. Look at the eye. Eye is none other than, you are right, homeopath. He just looked into the mirror and smiled. What did he see in the mirror? His reflection, you are right. It was an attractive smile. How was his reflection? His reflection was smiling. And how was the smile? The smile was very attractive. Now, I want to ask you a question. What is the other form of the word attractive? Attraction. Very good. It was an attractive smile. I made another earth-shaking decision. Earth-shaking decision, you can easily catch the meaning. It is not the decision which is going to follow. I would always keep that attractive smile on my face. Is it possible for this doctor to keep smile on his face forever? For a long time? To look more handsome, that is a clear one. Why did he want to keep that attractive smile on his face? The answer is very clear. To look more handsome. And he's again emphasizing, I was after all a bachelor and a doctor too on a top of it. Okay? Again he's emphasizing one more sentence. Again came that noise from the above. Now you can easily understand, there was some sound on the top of the house, not on the upper side of the house, but inside the house, on the top of the house above, there was a sound. I got up, lit a beedi, and paced up and down the room. Now you can easily understand, this man has a habit of smoking, beedi, cigarette. Okay, beedi is nothing but a Telugu word. I don't know, in English we can easily say smoking habit, cigarette habit. I got up, lit, the three forms of the lit are light, lit, very good. Now the same word has been used in somewhere else in our lesson, lighted, okay, yes or no? Okay, I got up, lit a beedi and paced up and down the room. Pace, P-A-C-E, pace, we discussed in our meanings. Paced means speed. Then another lovely thought struck me, I would marry. There he got a wonderful thought. How was the thought? Lovely thought, a beautiful thought struck his brain. Struck. I would marry. I would get married to a woman doctor who had plenty of money and a good medical practice. So she had to be fat for a valid reason. If I made some silly mistake and needed to run away, she should not be able to run after me and catch me. See the silly reason. Now answer my question. Why this man wanted to marry only such a fat woman? But that woman should be a medical practitioner. Why did he want to background woman with the medical department or a woman doctor? Because he is in the same profession. He wants to marry same professional woman. But there are some silly things in this question, in this paragraph. He wanted to marry a woman doctor, and that woman should have plenty of money and also a good medical practice. See this fellow, a poor doctor. He is very, very poor, living in a small room. And also there is one more reason. She had to be fat, such a stout woman. And there is a reason for this one. Here nobody, actually in our society, most of the fat women are not interested to be married by those people. I don't know why. So there is a valid reason, he says. If I made some silly mistake and needed to run away, she would not be able to run after me and catch me. This is a silly reason, I can say. And you can easily once again, you can say, this fellow is a silly fellow. Naughty fellow. He is not that much seriousness maintaining person. Okay? So all these are, he is just recalling and telling his friends. Okay, with such a thoughts in my mind, I resumed my seat in the chair in front of the table. What is there in front of the table? Chair, and there is a seat, and he was just resumed. He stopped all these thoughts and he stopped there. There were no more sounds from the above. Oh, no sound from the above, no hissing sound was coming. Suddenly there came a dull thud as if a rubber tube had fallen to the ground. There was some wonderful, not actually wonderful, a dull thud sound. Thud, let us see the meaning of the word thud here. Thud means dull, heavy sound. Okay, now let us go again to the paragraph. There was a thud sound that a rubber tube with a full of air could have fallen to the ground from the above. Surely nothing to worry about actually. Even so, I thought I would turn around and take a look. He wanted to just turn that side and look at that side. But did he look? Now I have a question for you. If he looked at that side, what he could have seen? Do you want to know what did he see? Now let us see. No sooner had he turned than a fat snake wriggled over the back of the chair and landed on my shoulder. Oh my God! What happened? Such a fat snake. Actually, he wanted to marry a fat, fat, fat woman. The woman should be a doctor. The woman should be a medical practitioner. The woman should be with a plenty of money. But now his thoughts vanished. Now I don't know what is the position of this doctor. The snake, such a fat snake. Yes, fallen on the chair, on his shoulder actually. The snake's landing on me and my turning were simultaneous. Simultaneous. Look at the meaning for this word again. Simultaneous. Done at the same time. Once again, repeat after me. Done at the same time. Okay. What are the two actions simultaneously happened? Tell me, my dear students. One is, snake landing on the doctor. Very good. What is the second one? Second one. Come on. Yes, the doctor turned towards his shoulder. Two actions simultaneously happened at the same time. Okay, now let us go to next paragraph. I did not jump. I did not tremble. I did not cry out. Then what did he do? Do you want to know the meanings of this word tremble? Let us see the meanings before discussing this paragraph. Tremble. Shake unwillingly. అంటే అయిష్టంగా అటు ఇటు వణికిపోవడం. స్లీదర్డ్ మూవ్ స్మూత్లీ. మల్టన్ మెల్ట్ టు లిక్విడ్ ఫామ్. లర్క్ బీ హిడెన్ దాగి వెయిట్ చేయడం. ఫీబలీ వీక్లీ. మస్కరా మాస్కర్ ఎక్కవా ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ అవర్ తెలుగు వర్డ్. వెమిలియన్ అ బ్రిలియంట్ రెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ మెర్క్యూరీ దిస్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఇన్ తెలుగు సింధూరం. ఓకే. Do you understand? If you want to know these meanings, you may take what is this called? You are right. Screenshot. Okay. I did not jump. I did not tremble. I did not cry out. Who is I in this paragraph? Doctor. Doctor did not jump. Okay. Repeat after me. Doctor did not jump. Doctor did not tremble. Doctor did not cry out. Can we say like this? He did not jump. He did not tremble. He did not cry out. So now you can easily understand how we can express past actions in English. How can we say he did not come? She did not play. She did not read. I did not go to school. I did not eat food yesterday. I did not come to class yesterday. Do you understand? Can you say like that? Will you write at least a few after the class is over? Okay, you are good. Now let us see. I did not jump. I did not tremble. I did not cry out. There was no time to do any such a thing. There was no time actually to do all these things, kada. The snake slithered along my shoulder and coiled around my left arm above the elbow. Look at this one. This is a part elbow. Okay, this is called elbow, and the snake coiled around means chuttukundi. Where? above the elbow, left arm above the elbow, the snake slithered along my shoulder. Slithered means ala ala ala, creep slowly down. The hood was spread. H-O-O-D, hood. You look at the look at my hand. This is called hood. What is this in Telugu? Padaga. Yes. Hood was spread out and its head was hardly 3 or 4 inches from my face. Oh my God. What an exclamation mark is also used. The snake was face to face. I was asking some students, what will you do if you are face to face with the tiger? My students answered, I will run away. I will close my eyes. Somebody said like that. Somebody said like that. Now I have a question for you. What will you do if a snake is face to face with you? Here is a doctor. This was just 3 or 4 inches from his face. Now you can easily say, he's face to face. Do you remember any god from our Hindu culture like that having snake in his on his shoulder and on his neck? You are right. It would not be correct to say merrily that I sat there holding my breath. I was turned to a stone. He was turned to a stone. Stone means, yes, you are right, rock. Here we can say, he turned to a statue. Statue. Okay, come again to. Statue is a game we play with our children. Like that, this man became a statue. Okay, he sat there holding even breath. He was unable to breathe. Uchvasa, nichvasa antaru telugulo. So, he stopped even the breathing. Okay, now the door opened into darkness. Actually, the door was open already. It was dark. The room was surrounded by darkness and the room also had a darkness because only a small lamp. In the light of the lamp, lamp, be silent. In the light of the lamp, I sat there like a stone image in a flesh. He was a quite natural like you and me, as a flesh and blood. Mamsamu, raktamu, anni unnavade kada. But he was standing there, not standing actually. He was sitting there like a stone. I felt then the great presence of the creator of the world and this universe. God was there. What was he thinking that? God was there in front of him. Suppose I said something and he did not like it. This is his thinking. Okavela devudu ikkada unnadu. Nenu ayanto I am just having conversation. I have a word with him. Nenu okavela edana chepte athaniki ishtam lekapothe. I tried in my imagination to write it. Write in a bright letters outside my little heart the words, oh God. He wanted to do something in his imagination. Imagine, you know, imagination means just uhinchukodam, live in a dreamy world. There was some pain in my left arm. It was as if a thick leaden rod, a rod made of a molten fire was slowly but powerfully crushing my arm. The arm was beginning to be drained off all strength. What could I do? Okay, dear students, he has been asking himself, what could I do? He was unable to do anything because slowly the creature, the god creature was just creeping down and he could do nothing. At my slightest movement that a snake would strike me, death lurked 4 inches away. Now this fellow has been thinking, this doctor, the death lurked 4 inches away, 3 or 4 inches away. Suppose it struck. What was the medicine I had to take? There were no medicines in the room. I was but a poor, foolish and stupid doctor. I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. Such a poor doctor. He studied something. He didn't have a good understanding over the medicines. He was not only poor in his health and wealth and well-being, but also he was not a capable person as a doctor also. he doesn't know medicines, he doesn't have medicines, he forgot the danger, but he smiled feebly, weakly smiled. What a poor doctor I am. Look at the word poor, write the pronunciation of the word, write the other form of the word, poor, yes, poverty, foolish, foolishness, okay, medicine, medical plants, we say sometimes. Okay, come again to another paragraph. It seemed as if God appreciated that, the snake turned its head. It looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. This fellow is very lucky. What did he do? He did nothing. He just kept silent. He was keeping his head. He was keeping his body calm. And snake itself slowly slithered down and went away to the mirror. It seemed if God appreciated that, the snake turned its head, it looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. What did the snake do? Snake looked into the mirror. And what did it look? It looked at its reflection. I do not claim that it was the first snake that had ever looked into a mirror, but it was certain that the snake was looking into the mirror. He was confirmingly telling that the snake was looking into the mirror, but he is not claiming, he is not telling this is the only snake which looked into the mirror for the first time. He is not telling that one. Was it admiring its own beauty? Was it trying to make an important decision about growing mistake or using eye shadow and mascara or wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead? He was just go on meditating all these questions on looking at the snake. Okay, let us go to next paragraph. So before going to the paragraph, I would like to ask you some questions. What would have happened next? Let us see these questions. Who are they in the paragraph? Something is missing here, but no problem. Who are they in the paragraph? Come on, answer the questions. Who are they in the paragraph? Yes, some villagers. What happened to his coat and bag? There were things like coat and bag in his room, but it was, you cannot see those things. They are disappearing. What happened to those things? Some thief might have entered, or the snake could have taken. Okay, why did the thief leave only his vest? You're right, thief came. Why did he leave only his vest? V-E-S-T, vest, we studied the meaning. Vest means undergarment on the upper part of a body. You will see in the picture. In Telugu, we call it bunny. How did the doctor feel? Doctor felt insulted. Doctor felt happy. My vest is here. I am very happy. Did he feel so? If you are in the place of a doctor, how do you feel or act? Come on. Your property like a bag, baggage, luggage, your coat, your shirts, all these things are looted. Only one dirty, small undergarment like a banyan is left. And now you are a doctor. How do you feel? Do you think it is an insult for you? What is your feeling after reading this lesson? What do you feel? Will you be brave or coward in your life? Tell me, my dear students. Just we have looked at the snake and the mirror lesson so far. We have one more slot to discuss about this lesson. Before that, just we looked at the picture just now. Answer those questions which I have given to you. And try to write the past actions like I did not play, I played. I played, I did not play. I came, I did not come. She laughed, she did not laugh. So it is better to construct at least 20 to 30 sentences which you can. My mother prepared curry. My father did not like it. Do you understand? Like this, you can write a few sentences of your own. You may make use of our textbook from page 1 to page 5. there are few sentences which just appear in past tense. Past tense is nothing but discusses completed actions. Maybe yesterday, maybe last year, maybe 2 years ago, maybe somewhere else in the past. Do you understand? We have so many things to discuss. Please don't forget to write a few past sentences which are possible for you. Write in your notes at least 20 to 30 sentences if possible. Take them to your English teacher, show them, or at least send them by WhatsApp. They will feel very happy. Let us meet in the next session. Bye. Thank you.